You're watching Local 4, home of ClickOnDetroit.com. WDIV Local 4 News Morning starts now.
From your iPods to laptops and tablets, headphones, really, kind of like these, they've become a staple. You see them everywhere. Many people, young people, old people, they're all using them. But could a certain type of headphone device actually be putting your health at risk? Joining us this morning is Dr. Sreek Cherukuri. He is an ear, nose, and throat specialist, and he's going to inform us about what some of the potential risks are. Good morning.
Thank you so much
for coming out. Of course, I brought this as an example, but during the break, we were getting prepared for this interview, and you told me that there is a certain amount of hearing loss that statistics are showing now, and it's because of the use of headphones and earbuds like these. Tell us what the problem really is.
Right, so over the last decade, it's become a more noisy world. Historically, Walkman-type radios and cassette players used to last a couple hours and not get that loud, mm-hmm. but now with the new technology, rechargeable batteries, the devices go all day, 12 or 15 hours. People will listen to music, and the volume levels can get above what OSHA recommends mm-hmm. is too loud for their workers. And so we're starting to see, actually, a University of Michigan study showed about 20% of teenagers have mm-hmm. a slight hearing loss. And we have to think that it's due to loud noise.
And we know that, of course, teens like their music louder. And then we talked about how some of the devices are actually designed in such a way that they go into your ear. They're right next to, as you described, the eardrum.
That's right.
Causing this problem.
Right. So the closer you are to the eardrum, the more direct the sound is and not filtered. Mm-hmm. And that can cause a louder volume.
And we're taking a look at some form of a diagram here. Can you explain what we're
right,
seeing?
So we're seeing an eardrum, which then takes the sound wave, vibrates it to the bones of hearing, which is those kind of the pivot items there, and then it signal goes to the inner ear and then to the brain, which processes and tells you what you're hearing.
And I like how you talked about the fact that this is an interpersonal sense that people often take for granted. Can you speak to that a little bit?
Right, because hearing is one of those senses that requires two people, mm-hmm. and if one person's neglecting it, either at the workplace or at home, many other people suffer. And there's a study in Britain that showed a higher risk of marital dissatisfaction or even divorce when one spouse had untreated hearing loss.
And some of that is selective hearing loss. But let's talk about a device that you have helped to develop that should help make approaching hearing loss more accessible, because we know that a lot of the hearing aids are very expensive, but
right.
you've designed something that's
so in my practice,
helpful.
Every day I'd see people that would benefit from hearing aids either at the workplace or in their home life. And they couldn't afford $1,000 to $3,000 price that Medicare or other insurances didn't cover. So we designed a low-cost hearing aid. We took out all the bells and whistles and just made a very high.
And we have an example of it right here. Let's hold up that. And of course, this is available at this MDHearingAid.com, and maybe we'll put the information on our website. And this is just under $200.
Under $200,
as opposed to thousands of dollars.
Right, in line with other electronics like an iPad.
Dr. Cherukuri, want to thank you so much. This is critical information. Like you said,
thank
people
you.
Will buy glasses all day long, but you want to protect your hearing.
Absolutely.
All right. Thanks again.
Thank you.